There you are. You don't need to ask. Of course you can sit here. I told you, the co-pilot seat is your seat now. You're the co-pilot, I guess. If you like. Or not. Don't touch anything. How are you holding up? Look, I'm a loner for a reason. You could probably, Cheechit are, sorry, my species are predominantly very social creatures, but you've been alone for the last 4 sleep cycles. I mean, I don't know if I should. The ship says you've been using the food dispenser, so I left you to it. But 4 cycles? I don't know. Am I failing you? I don't know what I'm doing. I don't even know who you are, what you like, heck, what your species is like. Was. Is. I'm no xenobiologist. I don't know what you need. You're my responsibility and time. You just need. Will you be okay? Yeah, stupid question. Where have you been sleeping? I locked bunk 1, but do humans even need sleep? Ah, one of the other bunk rooms. No, that's fine. I'm glad. Which one? Well, what did it say on the door? Oh, right. Yeah, you don't read orcs. The symbol on the left, what did it look like? Okay, bunk 6. That's really clever. Making the shape of the number with your manipulators. Yeah, like that. Fingers. Paws and fingers? Hands, okay. Well, yeah, I can't. Look. You have more hand fingers than I have tarsal claws. Plus exoskeleton, you know? Better, tougher, but less give. You wanna look? Sure, yeah, you can hold my claw. Yeah, I don't mind. You're being very delicate. I won't break. You endos are often like that, if you don't mind me saying. Yeah, my shell is pretty flexible. It's thinner on the extremities. You're really squishy, aren't you? What? I'm just watching your hand fingers. They're weird. Squishy with the hard bit in the middle, rather than the other way around. Hey, nothing wrong with weird. There are 14 sapient races from 8 ancestral planets amongst the citizenry. It's normal to run into weird. Don't worry about it. No, I was just thinking. Well, if I'm bringing you back to citizen space, would you be the 15th? The last time a new race was contacted was 3 epochs ago, long before I was hatched. Politics, son. I don't know how these things work. What's going to happen to... Well, first and foremost, I'm going to look after you. For a bit. Until we find you somewhere you want to... You're my responsibility, and I am not going to let anything bad happen to you. I'll take you wherever you want to go, get you set up with whatever you need, and then you need never see me again. Saints betide, no. I don't know how things were done back on, but no one's going to vivisect you. Ever. It's not the way things are done. You're precious. I mean, uncontacted species have protected status. Endangered species have protected status. People are going to be interested, I won't lie, but... Okay, maybe you'll be asked for some samples. Well, tissue, ichor, bone scrapings? Bone marrow, yeah. Alright, so you're familiar with how it works, good. Well, mainly for preservation and potential study. Last example of Sol 3 life and all that. Kind of important. But yeah, nothing you'll miss. I can't guarantee quiet, but people are going to be very interested in keeping you safe. If we take you to a council-run planet, the authorities will be tripping over themselves to ensure you have a long and comfortable life. Well, someone's got to find out. I can't just dump you on some far-off moon and leave you to it. We need to get you somewhere you'll be taken care of. Okay, hold on. You said a lot there that didn't... Lab rat, gilded cage, are those idioms? Yeah, idioms don't translate well. Yeah, see this on my neck? Universal translator. We'll have to get you fitted with one at some point since you can't understand auxiliary. Try again? I don't know. What you are, what you represent. Do you even know where to go from here? Yeah, neither do I. We are currently en route to Radian Station. It's as good a place to start as any, not too big. We can refuel, resupply, figure out what to do next. I know a place there. They do the best spice mints you will ever taste in your life. You're omnivorous, right? No, you'll be fine. We don't need to hide you or anything. For an outpost, it's pretty civilized. You'll probably get some funny looks. Just leave the talking to me and you'll fit right in, okay? Oh, if you meet any Aurons, try not to stare. Yeah, you'll know what I mean if you see one. So, where are your erogenous zones? What? No, really, what happened? What? Personal. Oh, was that a human thing not to do? Yeesh, sorry, I was just trying to be polite. Yeah. Oh, single species society, of course. Yeah, when loads of different species conglomerate together, knowing what's considered taboo ahead of time helps avoid awkward scenarios. Wars have started over ambassadorial faux pas in ancient history. Asking that is a common first greeting. Alright, I'll go first. If you meet a Cheechit, avoid here, these joints, and they're not erogenous, but the antennae are very personal. Uh-huh. Alright, got it, thanks. Oh, what about the neck? Yeah, listen. Our necks have thicker exoskeletons, but I know some of the fleshier endospecies don't like anyone touching their necks, weak spot or something. Yeah, there, you see? That's why we ask these things. You wouldn't have liked it if I'd held your neck, right? Yeah, that's a familial greeting on my planet, but apparently some endos find it threatening. Was that a smile? No, actually, was it? Your expressions are hard to read. Can you move your hair like our antennae? They're a big part of our body language. That would probably be easier for me to read. All right, whatever you say, Grumpy. I'm no human expert, but I think I'll file that under dubious. Gia. That's my name. Captain Noor Jiashik. This old girl's the Amaranth. Welcome aboard. What is. Oh, that's your name. Yeah, no, I can't pronounce that.